Hey everyone, in this tutorial we're going to take a look at material settings when bringing your character into Blender, and how to fix any material mapping issues you may encounter. If you haven't done so yet, please watch the intro tutorial for the CC3 Blender Tools in order to get that set up first. Our first step is to export our character from CC3. So let's go ahead and do that from the File menu, making sure we choose the Blender Export preset. As you may recall from the intro tutorial, we need to deselect Embed Texture and make sure we have Delete Hidden Faces, Merge Beard and Brows into One Object, and Bake Diffuse and Specular Maps from Digital Human Hair Shader all selected. Once we have our character imported into Blender, we can look at the import details, which provides some information about the imported character. Note that there is an item titled Key File. If you want to re-import your FBX file into CC3, you'll be prompted to include this file in order to import successfully. Under the Rebuild Materials section, you can toggle the shader mode between Basic and Advanced, with Basic using the PBR shader and Advanced using the Digital Human shader. There is also an Alpha Blend mode, which we'll discuss a bit more later. In the Material Setup section, you'll find a list of your character's materials. As you can see, the section corresponds with the Material tab in Blender. Below that is the Adjust Parameters section, which as you can see contains a number of different material parameters such as roughness, specular, and subsurface scattering that you can tweak in order to get the ideal result you want in Blender. Below that, there is also a section for micro-normal parameters which subtly modify the skin normal maps as you can see in this close-up. You can also adjust parameters for other sections of the body like I'm doing for the arm here. Below that, there's an option to refine the AO strength of your character's teeth as well. The most detailed section in terms of adjustment options is the eye section. The CC3 Blender tool contains a huge number of options for eyes. More noticeable parameters are the iris, color, and scale, as well as shadows. You can get into even more detail as well though, by adjusting parameters ranging from the texture and depth of the iris to the occlusion and the tear line. One of the most useful aspects of the CC3 Blender tool is that it transfers CC3's smart hair system over to Blender flawlessly. This means that you can tweak and adjust the same hair parameters in Blender that you could in CC3. It's important to start off by maximizing the strand global strength parameter in order to activate all of the hair shader effects. Here I've selected a cool looking fresh purple color for the roots, giving my character's hair an ethereal sort of appearance. If we want to change the eyebrows separately, then we need to have them selected first and go into the selected area and then adjust those parameters separately. I can do the same thing with the lower portion of my character's hair as well to refine the appearance. Besides adjusting the color, you can also tweak the subsurface scattering in order to give different visual results for how light affects the appearance of the hair. Okay, let's take a look at some potential material issues you may come across. You can see in this first example that there is an issue where the opacity for the eyelashes is incorrect. In order to fix this, just make sure the eyelashes are selected, and then change it to the eyelash material type. Under Rebuild Materials, you only need to rebuild selected, and from there just click on Rebuild Advanced Materials to solve the issue. If you find that your materials are having alpha blend issues, the CC3 Blender tool has a couple of buttons that allow you to change the alpha settings quickly. Here you can see me switching between the blend and hashed modes, which will also make the same changes in the Blender Material tab. You may also occasionally encounter an issue with single-sided materials. This will show up with backface culling enabled in Blender Materials, however if you select double-sided in the CC3 Blender tool, you'll see the issue will be resolved. That's about it for this quick video guys, thanks for watching, and be sure to check out our other tutorials for our CC3 Blender tool, as well as our forums over at forum.reallusion.com. I'll see you in the next video.